Starting with Dionysus. There's so many stories to tell. Let's begin. They saw. couldn't stand it, and they all jumped overboard, except one, who had wanted to set the prisoner free to begin with. As he, too, was about to jump, Dionysus caught him and changed back into his own form and told him to stay. Sessions, and men would go about singing and dancing as the wood spirits had sung and danced before Dionysus on his journey. Poets, too, would sing verses to the music of the lyre, and in these they told about the adventures of the god. At length, they began to have theaters and regular performances. And at the festival, great dramas and acted them out on stage. So Dionysus became not only the god of grape and wine, but in fact the god of art, passion, music, and theater and dance. So many of the ancient myth stories, like the legend of Dionysus, god of wine, with morals that provide the old storytellers, the oratorical contributors of morals, these myth makers, these myth communicators, and with short examples of exciting tales for kids and children of how to act and behave. These tales reflected important life lessons. The characters of these heroes in this type of fable demonstrated the virtues of courage, love, and loyalty, strength and perseverance, and leadership and self-reliance of having your own moral compass to not persecute people when the rest of your peers act. Teaches you how to follow your own, have the courage to follow what you know is right in the face of overwhelming dissent. Whereas the villains demonstrated all of the vices and were killed or punished by the gods. The old famous myth, story, and fable like Dionysus were designed to entertain, thrill, and inspire young listeners. So, that was Dionysus. Now let's see. mountains of Mount Olympus, and he was often called the sun god, because the Greeks thought that he brought the sun's light and warmth to man, as these are so necessary. Made this man promise that he would tell no one of his misfortune, but the man longed so to tell that at last he could stand it no longer. He went to the edge of a stream, dug a hole in the earth, and whispered into it the secret. Once a great queen named Niobe, who had six sons and six daughters. She was proud of her beauty and proud of her wealth and power, but proudest of all of her 12 children. She thought that they were so beautiful, she loved them so much, that she even dared to boast that she was greater than the mother of Apollo, who had but two children. This made, of course, the goddess very, very angry. She begged her son to punish the queen for the wicked bride she showed. Apollo, with his bow and arrow at his side, floated down to earth and hid in a cloud. There he saw the sun of Niobe playing games among the other boys in the city. Quickly he pierced one after the other of them with his arrows, and soon the six lay dead upon the ground. The frightened people took up the dead boys gently and carried them home to their mother. She was brokenhearted, but cried, "The gods have indeed punished me. Scarcely spoken place called Delphi. Here, there was always a priestess whose duty it was to tell the people who came there the answers which the god gave to their questions. She would place herself on a seat over a crack in the earth, out of which arose a thin stream of gas. By breathing this, she was made lightheaded for a moment. And then she was supposed to be able to tell the answer which Apollo had given. These answers were almost always in poetry, and though they were very wise sayings, it was sometimes hard to tell just what the god meant by them. Once a great king wished to begin a war and asked the advice of Apollo at Delphi. The priestess answered that if he went to war, he would destroy a great nation. The king thought that this must mean that he would conquer his enemies, and so began the war. But alas, he was conquered himself, and found that it was his own nation, in fact, that which would be destroyed. Although these oracles, as they were called, were so hard to understand, the Greeks thought a great deal of them, and would never begin anything important with the first without asking the advice of Apollo. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. As always, I appreciate you stopping by. Enough out of this channel.